Our topic is graphing with complex numbers. Imaginary numbers happen when a negative number is square rooted. Since there is no solution to that, it becomes positive and gains the symbol I. It is possible to graph in the imaginary plane. You do this by taking the complex number and graphing it with the imaginary number on the y-axis, and then on the x-axis having the real number. A complex number looks something like a plus bi, or x plus yi, and a is the real number, and bi is the imaginary number.
For the first example problem, you want to find out which half of the complex number is the imaginary and which part is the real. The part of the number that has I is the imaginary. And the other half is the real. Then you turn it into a coordinate on the grid, taking an imaginary number and putting it in the y spot. And take the real number and put it in the x slot. Then you graph it like you would a normal number with going left 3 for the negative 3, and then going up 5 for the 5. And this is on the complex plane.
Do we have another example problem for graphing points on a graph? You have x, y. For this 8 minus 7i, you would graph it by having the imaginary number on the y-axis and the real number on the x. So you would do 8. For this one, you would have 7 as the real, negative 5 as the imaginary. Graph that the same way. And then for this one, you have a negative real number, and you would do negative 3.
We chose graphing with imaginary / complex numbers because we wanted to further our understanding of how to graph different types of equations and points. It enhanced our understanding of graphing because it furthered our comprehension of graphing and showed us how to graph with complex numbers, something we previously only knew how to create and recognize, but not graph.